Hi, everyone. Peter Griffin. Welcome to the roast portion of the evening. Ladies and gentlemen, my son, Chris. Born on the highway, because that is where most accidents happen.
Peter!
But we're here to talk about Brian getting another year older. You know, I hear he can't even bury a bone these days without Viagra.
All right, I can take it.
And they say you can't teach an old dog new tricks, but I heard Brian just learned how to roll over and beg for an erection.
Okay, that's sort of just another jab at my penis, but sure.
On the positive side, Brian's latest book was a real page-turner. Yeah, I turned the pages into toilet paper, because Brian's old now and can't satisfy women through intercourse.
Peter, I'm fine. Are you sure this isn't about you not being able to perform on your anniversary?
I told you that in confidence!
Moved away, Buttercup had kittens.
What?
That's right. You're a grandfather.
My God, this is more pussy than even I can handle.
Is he gonna say giggity? Should I say giggity? Are other people allowed to say giggity? Giggity.
What?
Nothing. It's stupid.
Bagma, you gotta help us. We pissed off a bunch of ghosts, and now our house is gone, and we got no place to stay.
Peter, this is not the best time.
Glenn, are you coming?
Yeah, honey, I'll be right there. Wah! Wah! I'll be right there. Peter, I'm really slammed right now. Can you give me the short version?
What's going on in there?
Nothing. So, as you can see, my family's here, and, it's game night. We're playing sex.
To real jobs.
That's it, Fishman. Shirts off. I want to see who's got bigger pecs.
Peter!
Well, they look better when they're oiled up. Pass the salad dressing. Oh, no, it's an almost empty squeeze bottle. Hang on. It's all out. There's dressing on that salad. Give me that salad. Yeah, who's the better man now, Ross?
Tom, I'm standing here with Stephen Hawking, the first white man I've ever met who knows math better than me.
Thanks for coming to my big night, Brian. I see you got all dressed up in your exposed wiener.
Quack. One of those kids who gets a device that allows him to hear for the first time.
Billy, can you hear?
Yes!
Amazing! This is amazing! Your mom and I are going to get a divorce. I'm in love with someone else, and I didn't want to say it with the silly hands.
Out of control. Even though Brian's been trying to do my wife for years, and on some level I hate him for it.
Well, Brian's a complete dick, we all know that. But I think we're losing sight of the point that Bonnie's a weird slut who's always letting you know she's open for business.
What? When am I doing that?
Oh, come on, when are you not doing that? With that boo-boo baby voice and that still breastfeeding rack? Give me some of that!
Bonnie and I got you a big stick.
Wow, thank you. I'm gonna take it into the kitchen, and I don't foresee having any issues with that. Okay, I can make this work. Think, Brent, think.
Magic 8-Ball. Magic 8-Ball, I'm bored. Should I sniff my co-worker's hair? He told me to do it!
Mr. Griffin, if a magic 8-ball asked you to jump off a building, would you do that too?
Did it?
No, I'm just using that as an example of...
I listen to the toy!
Hello? Hey, Lois, what's up? Milk? Yeah, I'll pick some up at the end of my shift. Oh, gotta go. First fare of the night. I should really pick up that milk now before I forget.
You son of a bitch!
My mom was right.
What do you mean?
I'm not gay.
What? So, all those rounds of golf we played, those were all lies?
I'm so sorry. For the first time in my life, I felt like I belonged. And I wanted it to be true. So I pretended to be something I'm not.
You're going to choose to be heterosexual?
I thought being gay wasn't a choice.
Well, not for guys.
It was wrong of me to mislead you. I should go.
That was awful. That was just awful. What do you think, Mark?
I don't know, man. We didn't get the shots we need. Man, what do you think, Mike? I mean, if you saw action going on in front of you, would you know instinctively to center it in front of you?
I don't know. Could someone take my soda out of the icebox, please, so it doesn't freeze?
How are you, Betsy? Welcome to the show. You are a lovely young woman. And let me just get my hand up there and feel that one. And that one. And we're looking for something you shop for at the mall. 3 seconds.
Peter, why are there so many bottles of milk in the refrigerator?
Oh, thanks for reminding me. Everyone, some of the milk in the fridge is not milk, it's horse sperm. I'm a horse breeder now.
Oh, you're still here?
Yeah. After a wonderful night, I thought we could get some breakfast.
Clearly, you're not familiar with how this works. See, you're supposed to be already gone. There's no breakfast. Here, let me help you to the door.
You're a jerk, Glenn Quagmire! One of these days, you're gonna get what you deserve!
You better put something warm on. You got an icicle forming down there. Oh, hi, Meg.
Hi, Mr. Quagmire.
What can I do for you?
I was wondering if I could borrow some roofies.
Oh, sure. Just a sec. Roofies, huh? Pretty big pill for such a little girl.
Yeah, I know. But I asked someone to do me a favor, and they're not too keen on doing it.
Oh, I know what they're for, honey. So, how's school?
Oh, good. Thanks.
Studies going well?
Yeah. Mostly A's and B's so far this semester.
Oh, that's so great. Seeing anyone special these days?
Yay! Obviously, right?
Right, of course, yeah. Okay, well, listen, good luck with everything, and call me if you get arrested.
I will. Thanks.
That's what it's all about, Glenn. Don't rape it back, rape it forward.
All right, kids, now pay attention. All right, these are all of Quagmire's women organized by country. There's Brazil. There's Italy. And there's Thailand. Wow, they're young. We should go. Okay, Brian, let's go through Lois's drawers and look for clues. If you find any, let me know. And if you find the yo-yo she took from me, definitely let me know. Stupid Lois. I'm not gonna use it in the house. The Wendy's employee gave it to me if I promised to calm down.
Peter, this is a dead end. All I see here is your Nerf gun from last summer.
Oh, no way. She said I lost that. She deserves to be in jail. Hey! Suck on that, Lois.
That was very close to my eyes, Peter.
It wasn't close to your eye.
That's why I took it.
It was so far from your eye.
Griffin, where the hell is my daughter? She left me a note saying she ran off with Chris.
Oh, my God, Chris? That dirtbag hangs around my daughter, too.
So the man asks the bartender to recommend a good drink. The bartender says a grasshopper. So the guy orders a grasshopper. And then he's walking home, and along the way, he notices a grasshopper on the ground. So he says to the grasshopper, hey, you know there's a drink named after you? The grasshopper says, you mean there's a drink named Irving? So which one of you wants to lose your virginity?
Hi, sweetie.
Hey, Meg.
So, Meg, your birthday's coming up, huh? You excited about turning...
Meg, I got 16 candles for your birthday cake. How does that sound?
That's not right.
So, less... More, too many, not enough.
Oh, you stupid son of a bitch! You don't even know how old I am!
Meg, that kind of language is not appropriate for a girl your age. Or is it?
I'm gonna be 17, you jerks!
She's the jerk.
Wait a minute, a novelty? We used to date before I met Peter. So what are white women to black men?
A very pleasant page in our memory books.
Aw.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You banged my wife.
She did? No wonder I had so much room in there. Her womb was like one of those places where they reconstruct crashed airplanes.
Wait, Jerome's daughter is your girlfriend? Chris, can I speak to you for a moment, privately?
I voted for Obama once.
Dad, if this is about Pam...
Yes, it is about Pam. And I have something to say. Chris, she's not fat.
What?
I figured the day you came home with a girl, we'd have to back her through the garage. A little further, a little further, a little further. Whoa. Okay, all right. Now, do you prefer Fatty or Miss Boombaladdy?
Well, let's check. 9-11. Oh, there it is. We did it, Brian. We made 9-11 happen. High five!
All right, high five! Hey.
Well, that probably wouldn't look very good out of context.
Wow, Quagfest is a bigger deal than I thought. Oh, look, here's a simulation of what it's like to have sex with Quagmire.
Hi. Bye.
Was anybody gonna wake me up for the party? It's 6:30. I went down at noon. Now I'm gonna be up all night watching bad reality TV.
We now return to Uber driver Ninja Warrior.
First, he's got to swing on the gold chains across the cologne bath without dropping his e-cigarette. Next, he's got to pick up a rideshare customer. Now he's going to be late, but he's going to make it seem like the passenger's fault and not his.
Where the hell have you been?
I've been here, man. Maybe you press wrong button. I don't know. Now don't talk to me. I'm on 4 different phone calls.
I don't get it.
You thought this was going to be the flea circus from Coraline, didn't you?
I'm cursed with optimism. Ah, sweet. Harold Goldfarb, jetpack lawyer, is on.
Your Honor, may I approach the bench?
Is this so you can use your jetpack?
Yes.
I'll allow it.
That's the very potato I used in medical school to learn anatomy. I could let it go for $600.
What are we thinking, Lois? Yes?
No, we don't have that kind of money.
Fine, I'll buy it with my magic beans.
Those are Skittles.
There's no room in this world for dreamers anymore.
I wish I had a jetpack. My life would be better.
Ooh, 360. Oh, wait, 180. Very good. Now, let's get your height. All right, so you're 7'6", 180, with colorectal cancer.
I'm tall?
Everything okay, Dad?
Just adult stuff, buddy. Mom wouldn't let me buy a toy I wanted.
Do you own a home but can't afford the things you need to make your life more comfortable?
Yes. Wait, is that...
Hi, I'm Tom Selleck. Ask your nurse to turn down your breathing machine for a minute so I can tell you how reverse mortgage from Hey, All Right, Reverse Mortgages or HARM can help you.
Are you sure you want to do this, Peter? Seems a little reckless.
You do know that wearing a jetpack doesn't make you a lawyer, right?
Objection! Not supporting my dream of becoming a sky attorney.
Withdrawn.
I saw a thing, and now I want to do the thing. That's my thing. Now quit yapping and tape these leaf blowers to my back.
This seems like a trick.
I know this seems like a trick, but it's not a trick.
Oh, that's nice to hear. But is this his first rodeo?
Look, this isn't my first rodeo. And I wouldn't be here if I thought reverse mortgages would hurt anyone.
Well, I certainly believe Magnum P.I., but it's easy to say this stuff fully standing up. I wonder if he can half lean on a fence post and say it.
Peter, what the hell?
Oh, crap, there's one of them Chinese balloons.
Excuse me, I'm Japanese.
Oh, my God, I am so sorry. Please excuse my ignorance.
Hey, just take this opportunity to learn and grow.
I will. I will, balloon. I will.
Do you really want your adult kids fighting over your money after you're gone? Isn't it better to spend it all now so they don't have that option?
He's making good points. I'll just run this by Lois.
Men, please don't run things by your wives. Just go to www... I'm kidding. Here's a phone number as big as we can put it.
I'm getting my Mr. Potato Head.
I have to say, I'm weirdly impressed.
Yes, who would have thought a strange little guy like me could get super into tiny details of old furniture?
Well, if you need any help, I'm in.
All right.
Is that...
Yes, most antiques are just racist old packaging from iconic companies. Well, mostly syrup companies.
Wow, that's very racist.
Yep, whole blurry shelf racist.
I'm sorry, it's just... I took a shower once. I was so young. When they put me in the tub, I figured it was just to rub my tummy. What a fool I was. They stripped me down like an animal. And that's when things got real.
I'm Mr. Kiki, the swim teacher who doesn't have a pool and drives very far to other people's pools for lessons. After this lesson, I sit at Panera Bread until traffic dies down.
Panera Bread, where swim teachers from other towns wait out traffic.
At first, Peter tried to bathe me from the side, but then he realized it'd be easier if he got in. When it was over, they just wiped me down with an old beach towel and threw me in the yard.
Where did you get all this money?
It was easy. I took out a reverse mortgage, which is that thing where your house gives you free money.
I didn't get a parade. Hell, I didn't even get a chew toy.
Thank you for your shower.
I can't believe you took me to a retirement community.
Come on, it's not so bad. There's canasta and pickleball, plus the world's softest toilet seats. I can't poop now because I'm afraid of heights. Oh, here we go. All right, now I'm getting confidence. That's fine, I'll go it alone. Just like Meghan Markle and Prince Harry.
Sir, your millions from Netflix for no one knows what.
Put it with the rest of them.
Babe, time to do our daily $250,000 sponsored Instagram post for Del Taco.
I shouldn't have left the made-up nonsense.
You have a good eye. I just sold a piece by the same artist for 40. Lie.
That's a little out of my budget.
Well, I'd like 30, but I'd take 25. Lowest I can let it go for is 20.
Would you take 11?
Well, the frame alone is worth 30.
Highest I can do is 12.
Okay, but you gotta pay me before my wife gets back from the bathroom. She's gonna kill me over this price.
You won't be disappointed. Remember, you didn't think you'd like it when I had big giant traps either. Hey, babe, did you wash my singlet? I got a tournament up in Great Neck.
Peter, I can't wash your singlet and make you 100 egg whites.
Hey, Dad.
Oh, left yourself open to a near side cradle.
I am not a part of this.
Well, then tap out.
I tap out.
No tap outs.
You ever been with a man who knows the price of milk in 1942?
Can't say that I have.
It was a nickel. That was the price of everything then. A suit was a nickel. A house was a nickel. A dime was a nickel. Hemorrhoid donut for the lady?
A girl could get used to this.
Oh, how much for this?
You're gonna hate me. So everything you see here is for sale, except that. I don't even know how it got out here. It's supposed to be in the van.
Well, I really like it.
Brian, what did you do?
Oh, boy. That was a blunder on my part.
That's a pretty big blunder.
But look how much she loves it.
Do you love it?
I do.
Now, who wants to see me bite into an apple with my own teeth?
It's suicide!
I missed the moon landing. I ain't missing this.
Oh, that's amazing.
Used out of your league. That's what's happening here.
You hearing footsteps, Gramps?
How's about a little contest? Whoever sells the most by end of day tomorrow is the flea market champ. The loser gets out of the game. For good.
Fine. You're on. And by the way, there was a dead cricket in the teapot you sold me.
Oh, no.
I know.
Could you reach that cigar box full of dominoes? My grandchildren are coming and I want them to do something fun. Oh, such a strong boy. Here, have a chicken stick.
You carry candy in your pocket?
Of course. All old ladies are 70% pocket candy.
Wait, only one guy would accept delivery of so many Hawaiian shirts.
What is it, boy? Man, I love being paid for reverse mortgages in Hawaiian shirts.
Werther's? Butterscotch? That weird strawberry candy with the goo inside? You guys are like walking piñatas!
Oh, it's so nice to be touched.
Well, this is just great. I'm going to die in here and I'll never take a shower.
Maybe you won't, but we will.
Really? Thanks, Bri. The poop was in there when I got in.
I'd be much obliged if you'd go ahead and open up for me.
How did you do that?
Well, this ain't the first leg to which I've pitched woo.
Being the youngest, healthiest people here sure has its perks. It's like everyone wants a piece of us.
Before we harvest the organs of these two young meatbags, we need to decide who gets what. So if you want a body part, call dibs now.
Oh, Brian, look. It's this antique's last day selling antiques.
You alls can eat my dust.
Oh, we got quite a showdown here today at Flea Market Regionals, Jim.
Grandma's little loft has the experience, but don't count out the Brian, the bitch, and the wardrobe.
Yeah, I'll take the udders and the hooves.
What? That's not a cow.
That's a guy? But I saw him eating grass earlier.
Yeah. We're donating the brain to science. No one take the brain.
And the question we've been hearing the most today, why does a flea market have announcers?
Well, sometimes major network announcers have one too many at a golf tournament and hit a guy in their car and then have to work their way back.
Morning, Peter. I brought you some calcium-rich milk. It'll make your bones strong so I can swim again.
Thanks, Art.
Don't thank me. The cow did most of the work.
I was about to open a storage container fresh from Tempe. Come on by.
What? How is that possible?
And in crunch time, the game just slows down for a veteran booth like Grandma's Little Loft.
A large Native American-looking teen has grumpily plopped down on a camp chair with an iPad at Bruce's booth.
Lois, would you be a dear and lift this fruitcake that's the same weight as my grandson?
Sure.
Full range of motion, firm grip.
This could be the nail in the coffin as other booths have started shaking their misprescribed opiates in salute.
They call that the battle rattle, and it's the ultimate flea market show of respect. This one's all but over.
Time for your breakfast eye exam. Which line can you read?
Well, I can read Gledjeb.
That's not a word. It's just random letters in a row.
Really? I thought it was Dutch.
Hey, they said my name!
Don't be so self-centered. They could mean Gledjeb Opeldark.
And of course, the old guy who last minute decides he wants to keep his stuff has never really been a factor.
For him, it's more about telling people where he got the stuff.
Oh my God! Well, that's not so bad. Hard to misinterpret that.
Hold the phone. Looks like we got a guy bringing his home trash to the flea market garbage can.
And this is where the lone garbage can being right by Grandma's Little Loft could come into play.
Sure looks like a bag of mostly full diapers and half-eaten burritos.
And that's just a bee's dream bag.
Hey, we just wanted to say you want...
I'm gonna gut you like a fish and scoop out your insides right after I parallel park.
Peter, come on!
Sorry, Lois. As a man, I'm required to watch other men parallel park.
Peter, he wants to kill us! Let's go!
And once that money belt is zipped, it's official! The Brian, the Bitch, and the Wardrobe win Flea Market Regionals! What a comeback!
Boy, you said it! I told ESPN I'd quit after a Magic the Gathering tournament, but this time, I'm serious.
You gotta cut the wheel.
I am cutting the wheel.
Now the other way.
This is the other way, jerk.
No, left. Cut left.
Hold back. Cut left. Now I'm involved.
Right.
Hey, before I go, would y'all be willing to sell your whole inventory for $9?
Would you do 11?
No.
You got yourself a deal. I never want to come back here. Everyone, you're all within 500 feet of a school.
Over 200 arrests were made that day. It's still known in flea market lore as Extinction Sunday. I'm Chris Griffin, and my brother and my dog left me in a very hot car.
Oh, they shrunk the spaces so they could make more money.
Sir, this is a standard space on a public street. Nobody's making money here. Hi, Shannon, the line producer, said I could have another plate of lasagna.
That's not Shannon's call.
This ought to take care of it. And hey, just to make sure we're good, how'd you like a line on the show?
Blue Bloods.
It might not be just saying the show.
I understand. Tom, would it be possible for me to get another plate of lasagna?
That's not my call, Peter. That's Shannon's call.
It's not Shannon's call! Man, this place is crazy. Can you believe Joe was in the dark about all this?
Did you get the legs? Damn it! No. It's fine. I'll see if I can get Cleveland to go down there next week.
Follow that car.
First time in a big city? Blue Bloods. That last line was improvised.
Oh, look out, Ryan Stiles, huh? I'm just glad we don't have to worry about losing our house anymore.
Me too. I guess I learned celebrities always do the right thing once you publicly guilt them into it.
Hey, bud, how was Florida?
Having a little trouble this morning.
No, I'm doing great. Look, I already got Stewie and Brian changed.
Oh. I can't believe Peter's lost his voice. How's he gonna insult Meg now?
Well, I don't know if it's gonna work, but he brought a whiteboard.
Meg's got the ball. Peter, quick, write something mean. You're doing to this game what R. Kelly did to all the... Yeah, no, I'm not saying the rest of that.
Is everyone okay?
I swallowed my retainer, but I'll do a little stool fishing later.
Well, there's two things you can do from here. Break it off or go full scumbag. If you're interested in going scumbag, I sell a starter kit. It includes a second phone, fake addresses, and some golf shirts.
I don't golf.
Nobody does. Golf was invented purely so husbands can cheat on their wives. A six-hour game in a completely different town where you need special shirts? I don't think so.
Pumpkin Spice. Sounds like a reject from a female British pop band.
Quit tossing your scarf over your shoulder to punctuate your jokes.
You know what, Peter? I like me. Look, guess your weight. With a line that long, I'll guess my own weight. 30 minutes. Oh, see you in a few. Got scarfed up.
Daddy, I sort of lost Tatum.
You what?
I swear it was an accident.
Don't worry, Lois. We'll split up and look for her.
On it.
Damn it, Chris. Now that's going to be in our Fox promo.
Sorry, Dad.
Tonight on Fox, Chris Griffin meets Chris Griffin?
Ah, there it goes.
Sorry.
Oh, my God, this is worse.
I feel amazing. Like a bride on his wedding day.
At last, my love has come along.
Can you come upstairs and tell me if this gray chicken smells funny?
Be right up, babe. Oh, man, this is worse than...
Straight flush. You got a strip.
What about tonight?
What?
Oh, did you say I'm never gonna get out of here?
No, I was telling my horse to get naked.
Oh.
I'm your mother. I can feel your lies in my ovaries.
The doctor said those were cysts.
From your lies?
They're not gonna talk, Lois. I say we hook them up to the lie detector.
Peter, that's not a lie detector. That's a ride-on sex machine.
It is? Well, it got me to sing like a bird.
Stop rolling it into rooms.
Not only did I not give away your book, I'm launching an investigation, and I'm gonna nail the guy who did it.
Uh-huh.
And maybe it's more than one guy. Maybe it's a ring. A deep ring I can only penetrate by nailing a bunch of guys.
Wait, are you still talking about my book?
Oh, yeah. Maybe it's too many guys for me, and I have to bring in a private dick. Close the door on your way out, Brian. I need privacy to think about dicks for hire.
We paid a lot of money for that house, and taking the ass end of a shampoo bottle barely makes a dent into their hull.
There. Definitive proof that your mother always describes big things as being smaller than they are. Did you hear that, Chris?
We've all seen it, Dad.
Don't test me, starling. A census taker did that once, and I ate his liver with dry Cheerios and a mashed-up banana.
You can't go through here. It's only for people who work for Miss Ryan.
You have to let me through. I'm Ed Sheeran.
You're not Ed Sheeran. You're a weird-looking baby with an English accent. Oh, my God. Right this way, Mr. Sheeran.
My mama always said life was like a box of good and plenty. Most people just throw it away.
Well, they made it through the whole season. Now can I have my own show, Peter?
Quagmire, you're a rapist.
Too competitive, but I was the breath of fresh air that the stuffy tennis world needed. I was born into a real tennis family. On my first birthday, my mother gave me a little head. Hey, thanks for coming out with just me, Peter. There's something very important I need to talk to you about.
Am I adopted?
What? No, what?
Are you getting divorced?
I'm not even married.
We're moving again because of the army?
Well, it's a big move up for me, and you're going to get your own room? And I mean, no, that's not... Look, what I'm trying to tell you is I saw Lois strutting around your front yard, basically putting on a sex show for Joe, and he was into it.
What? He was? Are you sure?
Trust me, Peter, when it comes to sex, I know what I'm talking about. Like, did you know 46% of people picture someone else when they're having sex with their spouse?
Wow, did you read that in an article?
Nope, I do all my own research.
Mmm.
Who are you thinking of right now?
Chris Pine?
Huh, he's doing well this cycle.
Oh, you think he's so wonderful? Last night he screwed the cocktail waitress.
I'm sorry, ladies. I have deceived you. So I'll just collect my free au pair. And one for my wife. And I'll be on my way.
Oh, my God!
Everybody, this is Joan.
Hi.
Hello.
De uniden, hablendeth arweth hal uniden, leth hansed deun, quag mandir.
Dena den re dun, habldeth mithrendir ve on hel hesano. Hey there. It's nice to pleasure your acquaintance. Would you like to go out to dinner tomorrow night?
I'd love to.
Oh, that was great.
Sure was. See ya.
But you said we were going to get married.
Oh, I only said that so you'd get googity my gishmoigan. Kira, that was an amazing night. Sorry I can't drive you to work. I gotta go sit in my den until you leave.
Oh, that's okay. I'll just take the school bus.
Wait, what? You drive a school bus?
No, silly. I take the bus. I'm in high school.
What the hell? You said you were 23!
Yeah, and you said you love me.
Well, I guess you got me there. Hey, Peter. Oh, Falcon. Cool. Hi, Falcon. Whoa, easy there, fella.
Xerxes. His name is Xerxes.
What does Xerxes eat?
Rodents. Now, if you'll excuse me.
What the hell? Peter, make him stop!
Hey, what do you got going on down here, Quagmire? You got a rodent situation?
No!
Well, Xerxes seems to think there is.
Get him off, Peter!
Admit you got a rodent in there.
Peter!
Admit it!
Oh, you scared him out the front! Tony, come back! Hello, gorgeous. How old are you?
18.
All right, and I just recorded you saying that, and hi, I am Glenn Quagmire.
Courtney, nice to meet you. You don't look like you're in high school.
I got held back. You like getting held back?
Sometimes.
Hello, my name is Glenn Quagmire. I am a neighbor of yours on Spooner Street. I am here to inform you that I am a sex offender.
Seems as though you could have had some of that memorized.
Glenn, what the hell's going on?
It turns out that girl I took home from Peter's party last night is in high school.
Oh, my God!
Does this mean you're gonna move to Europe to make movies?
How in the world did you not know she was underage?
Well, in retrospect, she did ask a lot of questions about To Kill a Mockingbird. So anyway, what I'm trying to tell you is, some of the guys thought we should get a divorce.
What?!
But I told them they didn't know what they were talking about.
Good, because if you ever left me, I'd have to cut myself. And then I'd cut you. I love you, Glenn.
I love you too, insane woman I'm having second thoughts about.
What?
Oh, that. And initial here.
What is all this?
Oh, these just say if anything should happen to you, I'm not responsible, blah, blah, blah. I'm just boring myself.
Quagmire, sorry to bother you, but we're following up on a tip. Did you have sex with this underage girl?
I don't want to go to jail, but I really want to take credit.
Quagmire, I'm afraid you're under arrest for statutory rape.
All right, but let me just send the pictures I took of her last night to all my friends.
Oh, yeah! Boom! You're disgusting. Take them away. We've got all the awesome evidence we need.
Oh, Glenn. Oh, giggity!
Wait, did you just say giggity?
Yeah, sorry. Sometimes I just blurt that out when I get excited.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God! Here, rub this up and down on the inside of your cheek.
Giggity.
Ah! Stop saying that!
What is it, Glenn? What's wrong?
You're my daughter!
Oh my God!
Wow.
Quagmire said he did with the girl.
He said he gave her a frosty gym.
And can you please explain to the courtroom what a frosty gym is? Sir, you're under oath.
Well, it's when you urinate in a condom and tie it off, freeze it, and then the woman, pretends it's a man.
Thank you.
He's a good guy!
We're gonna fake your death.
All right, fellas, I think we did it. This may be the most absolutely perfect fake death in the history of fake deaths.
What do you guys want?
Joan, you mind if we come in? There's been an accident.
We gotta get him to wash that hand.
Yeah, I'll text Lois, see if we can't all come up with something.
Just reply to that last gif she sent of the sloth putting on the headphones.
I love that one. Is it weird that we're in a group text with our friend's wife, but not our friend?
No, what's weird is that your Bitmoji can walk.
I'm allowed to have legs in the phone world.
This is, not gonna be easy, but, it's something you should see. So anyway, here's Quagmire walking through the park, minding his own business. I just happened to be there with my video camera when a ninja shows up! And then a Nazi came! And then a evil pots and pans robot! Destroy! Destroy!
Quagmire, but I still need a body to take back with me, so...
No! You can't take him!
This is probably not cool, just throwing it out there. She was suicidal.
She was?
Yeah,
absolutely.
I had heard that, too.
And her last name was Quagmire.
Well, good enough for me. I gotta go. I got tickets to Celine Dion. I'm not gonna kill her. I'm just gonna watch her die on her own. Anyone? Anyone?
It's good to have you back, Quagmire.
It's good to be back, Peter. Hey, Death? Can you leave that body here for another 5 minutes?
That's Quagmire! I imagine you're probably wondering what happened to the body. Well, we thought of that. Oh, no! Quagmire's dead! Wait, we might still be able to save... Oh, no! Dun, 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 dun,
dun, you're doing great. Now roll it.
What? No way.
Don't worry. You're a Quagmire. It's in your blood. Grip it and rip it.
Okay.
Atta girl. Perfect. No, we're not doing that. I got my daughter with me today, you perverts.
He's not doing it today.
Ah, shoot.
Another time. Probably got his kid with him.
We are so, so sorry for your loss.
Is this a joke?
I wish it were, Joan. I wish it were a joke. But these things happen, you know? You go for a walk in the park one day, and wheelchair ninjas and Nazis and pots and pans robots show up to kill you, and dinosaurs show up to eat the remains. You've seen the news.
You're not fooling anyone.
Come on, mate. One more before the missus notices I'm not snoozing on the couch.
Too late!
Hey, careful, Quagmire. Don't get too close to that thing.
The hell? Did I just get laid? Hey, if I could rearrange the alphabet, I'd put you and I together. Hey, you must be a parking ticket, because you got fine written all over you. Hey there, I don't want to come between you, or do I? That's awful, that's awful.
Looks like somebody's hungry.
All right.
House.
Yeah, you're overreacting, Lois. And you can't spell overreacting without ovary. Because you're a girl.
I'm not overreacting.
Hey, just an FYI. Really no reason to go into any greater detail than this. Stewie should probably never use this pacifier again.
Okay, so I'll talk to him tomorrow?
I'm doing great. Well, hey, listen, I was really sorry to hear about your dad.
Oh, that means a lot.
Yeah, I'm sorry I couldn't make it to the wake. I was out of town.
It's okay. Thanks for the flowers.
Oh, it's the least I can do. Hey, Chris, get over here. You gotta meet my buddy, Bob Hanley.
Hi, Mr. Hanley. I'm Chris. I heard a lot about you, sir.
What's Dad doing over there with Chris?
Oh, he's telling him that he's no longer his favorite son.
No! No, Daddy! Daddy! Daddy!
I didn't even tell him. He just does not like to be touched.
Lighting his cigar right about...
Stewie, help! It hurts! Reverse the pill! Let me die!
Ooh, I wish I could, but the pills were in the house, so... Yeah.
Stewie! Stewie! away!
Peter, that was a private conversation.
That doesn't change the fact that you want to steal my wife.
Hey, get your hands off me.
Trust me, I bought the absolute latest issue of Archie Comics, and this is what the kids are wearing.
Oh, hey, fellow teens. Wait a minute, teenagers don't have wheelchairs. No! How is that possible?
I don't know, but I better make it look like there was a struggle. Someone punched me in the face.
I'm a good friend to you.
All right, they're probably holding a below deck. You take the right side, I'll take the left. You're gonna need this.
What? I've never killed anybody before.
Relax, they're Arabs. People will still be rooting for you.
Hey!
Son of a bitch.
Oh, this is like a video game.
Escalate me. Stop! Wait! I want Mrs. Padbury Wilkerson back! Sorry, Mrs. Padbury Wilkerson is in the loo!
Bring back that southern guy!
Sorry, I'm busy watching Mrs. Padbury Wilkerson use the john.
Can I talk to someone else? Literally anyone?
I'm Gilbert Gottfried, and I was fired by Aflac for no reason.
Well, there was some reason.
Shipping reports filled out by 5 o'clock today.
Shut up, Kyle.
I'm Peter Griffin. I'm a dorky, fat, numbnuts.
Kyle, I said shut up.
You're a poop nose.
How fast you were going, sir?
Peter?
Hey, Cleveland, this is just so we can talk without getting spotted by Lois or Donna. I need you to step out of the car, sir.
Peter, there's gotta be a better way.
He's got a knife! Sorry, Cleveland, it's gotta be authentic. Stay down! Stay down! Cleveland, try to grab my gun. Oh, trying to grab my gun, are you?
Hey, rookie, save some for me.
Wow, the whole gang's back together.
Shut up! We don't need you in this town!
Badass, give me your wallet!
I could give you my wallet, but what I think you really want is love.
It's true.
Right here in Italy.
Passports.
We don't need them anymore. Kids, I got an announcement.
He's wearing a rubber.
We're staying in Italy. We're Italian now. What?
Are you kidding?
Well, if we're gonna be Italian, I guess we should stop murdering our brothers.
Where are you at?
You break my heart, Chris. You break my heart.
He'll win this game. Wait for someone else to win and steal his card.
G27. Bingo!
It's go time.
What do we do? Sneak up behind him?
Nope, he's got cataracts. Follow my lead.
Bingo, bitches!
Bingo.
Really loco unless I shivved someone, and you're the one guy without gang protection, so...
Sorry, Quagmire. As a not cop, I have to shiv a guy in the Latin gang and then blame it on Cleveland.
No one made me do this. I'm just sick of your overt racism.
Guys, stop! Stop! Look at us. We're shivving each other on Thanksgiving. Oh, wait, no one shivved Cleveland.
Oh my God, what did you do?
He was supposed to get away. It was gonna be harmless 80s fun.
You killed the gopher!
He's all right?
No! He's not!
Way to kill two birds with one stone. Like this. The key to that, Lois, is big rock, small birds. Oh, and I also figured out how to achieve two goals with one action.
Oh, no!
Goodbye, terrible women. Evelyn? Evelyn? It looks like somebody's mom died or something. I don't know. You'll take care of this, right?
Boo! Let's see what we got in this picnic basket. Tell the other bears what you just saw.
Look out!
Oh, my God!
Holy crap!
Oh, man, Joe is going to be so pissed!
Well, thank God all we hit were those trash cans.
Oh, my God! Oscar!
Tell my ex-wife to go herself.
Very on brand. Right up to the end.
Okay, that was weird.
That was weird.
Right?
Oh my God, so weird.
I tell you something, if he touches my daughter, I'm gonna be kicking butts and taking names. And then giving those names to other people whose butts I kick. What's your name?
Derek.
What's your name?
Michael.
You're Derek now. All right, Meg, stay incredibly still. I'm gonna whip that cigarette out of your mouth. And maybe not slice your face in half.
Dad, I don't want to do this.
Stay still. Okay, that's pretty cool, too.
Hey, Dad, that's a cool whip.
I thought you couldn't understand me.
Lois, I've hired some 1980s black breakdancers to do their routine on your stomach.
Peter, come on. I'm having this baby, and that's the end of it.
But Lois, if they do it good enough, they'll save the rec center from being torn down and replaced by some mall. Ozone, Turbo, do your thing. Oh, no. Lois, those are 90s black guys. Those aren't 80s black guys at all. Run!
We're here to dance for the kids.
Run, 80s black guys. You're...
Holy crap, what happened?
Well, I think we simply found your true height. Before years of poor posture and wear and tear crushed your spirit and your spine.
Wow.
Mr. Griffin, let's discuss risk factors. Do you lead a lifestyle that's sedentary?
Pet sedentary?
I'm saying you need to strengthen your core.
If I ever see you anywhere near my house, I'll blow your head off! Now lay there and die, you piece of crap!
All right, everyone. Because today is Christmas Eve... Not yet, Griffin. I thought it might be a nice treat to... Griffin! Thank you. To let everyone leave a little bit early.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a Lincoln AKC.
The Family Guy Christmas Special, brought to you by Lincoln. Lincoln, what are we doing?
It'll be good for the kids. Nothing reminds you more of what you have than watching a grown man poo right through the split in his pants. Now let's finish decorating before your father gets home.
Okay, I'll put the Kanye canes in the stockings.
You know, it's just like, you know, music and fashion, all that. You know, I can't be stopped. Whatever I do, you know, I just won't be...
And he's headed right to the bar.
The clam's on the other side of town. He went out of his way to do this.
We now return to 'Twas the Night Before Christmas, as read by Norm MacDonald.
'Twas the night before Christmas. Wait, 'twas? What's 'twas? Eating murderer, right? Oh, right, was. 'Twas!
Well, I gotta get home. Every year we gather round and play Oh Holy Night from our favorite holiday album, A Very Slow Christmas with Peebo Bryson.
Sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah. Worship the Jesus child and praise his mother mild.
Coming this holiday season, it's Star Blizzard, using laser technology to shower your home in a blizzard of dazzling lights.
So much easier than stringing Christmas lights.
I can light up my whole house for just pennies a day.
After that, take my cousins to the airport and pick up my other cousins at a different farther away airport. Then shovel and salt the walk. Then shovel and salt the driveway. Then shovel and salt Mrs. Whitaker's driveway. She's 96 and has no one to help her. We need 4 netted bags of cinnamon pine cones. Get the bags at Hobby Lobby and the pine cones at Pier 1.
Fourth?
Coach, where are you guys going?
Every year, my parents invite us to their house to enjoy Christmas in Newport. And every year, we don't go because you don't want to. Well, this year, I am going and the kids are coming with me.
Go ahead. I'm fine by myself. I'll just watch my Patrick Swayze movie and take a 2-full bath.
Peter Griffin.
Hello? Santa?
Santa? You think Santa could fit into a pair of 22-inch waist jeans?
Patrick Swayze? How is that even possible? You're dead!
Haven't you ever seen Ghost? Peter, you're in trouble. You've lost your Christmas spirit. So I'm taking you on a journey to Christmas Past to find it.
Oh, wow. This is my old house from when I was a little kid.
That's right, Peter. I've taken you all the way back to the year 1970, 80, 90.
I'll never forget that year when President Richard Reagan Clinton lied to the American people. Oh, hey, look, there's my friend Holden.
Merry Christmas, Peter.
He could still talk then. I wonder what happened to him.
I gotta go! I gotta go!
Hold it in! Hold it in! Hold it in!
Hold it in! Hold it in! Hold it in! Hold it! Hold it!
I guess I am. All right, everyone, grab your hot ciders and gather around the speakerphone. It's time to call my grandmother, Nana Pewterschmidt.
Wer ist das?
Nana, hier ist Kater. Fröhliche Weihnachten.
Fröhliche Weihnachten.
Ich bin hier mit Louis.
Merry Christmas, huh?
Oh, my God, she's doing that flirty laugh she does. It's subtle, but when you've been married as long as we have, you notice these things.
You're very funny, Lance. You're a very handsome, funny man. Now let's see that penis.
Yeah, see, again, if you read between the lines, she's flirting. Why, this is...
I'm the ghost of Christmas yet to come. I'm shaping your future. You will see... Oops. That's what happens when I talk while I'm doing this.
Is this how Jonah Hill was made?
I can't believe our buddy's dead.
I know. And it's so sad. He left his family.
That guy!
That's Lois's new husband, Lance.
Wow. I finally had the guts to leave her. Good for you, Peter. What about the kids? How are they doing?
See for yourself.
All right, everybody, I'm off to Colombia.
Chris got into Colombia?
South America, where I will attempt to smuggle drugs back into the country in my rectum.
Dead? But how?
You died from a fire started by your MILF on a shelf.
Want to see some pictures of my teenagers?
No, Karen. Look, I haven't watered my Christmas tree for a few weeks now, so could you watch your really long cigarette, please?
Did I tell you I went to the mall with my daughter and an employee thought we were sisters?
Yes, many times. I don't understand. Don't lose your Christmas spirit. It's disgusting in there. He eats garbage in his own poo. Please, Peter, don't lose your Christmas spirit. This is no life for a person. Please, Peter. He ate Lois's trash. There's tampons in there. Please, Peter. Keep your Christmas spirit. Please, Peter. This is no life for a person. Please, Peter.
Christmas is perfect, isn't it, Mom?
Almost, Meg. Almost.
Yeah, it is. Except every time Grandpa bends over to get a present, his robe opens up.
Let's see. I think this is for Chris. Good God. Looks like 2 eggs in an old handkerchief.
Christmas, everybody! And for my beloved wife, a lawn chair that was 80% off because it's winter.
Oh, Peter, I can't wait to drink outside in this.
And finally, for Meg, a clock radio with an iPod jack for the iPods they don't make anymore.
Dad, you've never bought me anything before. Are you sure this is for me?
Of course! Na-na-na-na-na
for the weekend. Mom, what's he doing?
I don't know, Chris. Let's just keep opening presents. He'll tire himself out.
Great idea. Here's one from Meg.
And here's one for Stewie. And here's one for my beautiful daughter. Sweetie, come help me with this.
Peter, come on. Time to get dressed for our Valentine's Day dinner. We don't want to be late for our reservation.
Reservation?
Yeah, I decided we're going someplace nice this time. Not like last year when we went to the Outback Steakhouse. But it's out, as in the gay way.
We'll get to the specials, but first, I need to tell you, I'm gay.
You want to tell us what the holy hell that was?
I'm afraid it's something we made up that we finally need to deal with. You see, years ago, when Chris was in preschool... Peter, poor Chris didn't get a single Valentine today from any of his classmates.
What? Why not?
Apparently he's not well-liked.
A purple Vespa to bring candy and sweet notes to children who've managed to not use any swears in the last year.
He does?
Uh-huh, and he has a long beard.
Oh, and he's got an eye patch. But not for medical reasons. He just likes the look. Plus, he wears a Cat in the hat, and sometimes a scarf, no matter what Lois says, because it gives him a...
I go down to the video store and put my hand on Love Actually at the same time as a woman, and I go, oh, ho, 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 ho.
What about you, Brian? What are your plans for Valentine's Day?
What? No real plans, I guess.
Ha! Looks like Brian's the only guy with nothing going on.
Well, you could come over to my house, Brian.
I thought you had that whole thing with Bonnie.
Well, Brian, if you're stuck being a single loser, you might as well just embrace it.
Mm. Oh, yeah. Oh. Wait a minute, what am I thinking? Chocolate is poisonous to dogs. I better stop or...
Happy Valentine's Day!
Stop the damn banging!
Enough now to know the truth. He doesn't exist.
No, you're both lying!
What are we gonna do? It seems like there's no getting through to him. You know, if Chris is this hard to convince, we may just have to kill Arthur Valentine.
What? What do you mean?
Maybe we make Chris believe that Arthur Valentine...
Bands, web shooting, Spider-Man, an old pet rock, an antique clock, a ton of red Play-Doh. Colored pencils, lots of nickels, half a jar of Vlasic pickles, banjo strings, chicken wings, a single by Skilo.
I didn't poop those items. They were in my tummy, 'cause they all look yummy.
He didn't poop those items.
Shake.
Nice to meet you. I'm Ellie.
What are you in for?
I got this small cut, and they wanted to bandage it so I'd stop chewing the crap out of my foot.
Oh, that sucks. I love chewing the crap out of my foot.
I know, it's the best. But while I was here, I also had to get... a prescription filled?
Hey, you think you could be with me right here in this place?
Oh, yeah, sorry, Stewie. It's just, I met someone amazing the other day at the...
Chris, come down here, quick! I see Arthur Valentine outside. I think he's come to say hi.
Really?
Yeah, look!
Oh, my God. Hi, Arthur! I love you so much, and I haven't cussed once today! Dad, get the bowl of tuna from under my bed!
That Jackson Pollock. You know, I mean, I know they're not supposed to be that bright, but that was pretty genius. You know, I mean, leave it to a Pollock to just grab the paint with his hands and just start chucking it everywhere. I mean, it's great.
It's pronounced Pollock. But, Brian, you don't have to keep trying so hard to impress me. I already really like you.
You do? Thanks, I...
See, Nancy, will you make me the happiest man in the world by turning a blind eye to the AIDS crisis and ineffectually trying to warn young people about drugs?
Yes! Oh, yes, Ronnie, yes!
If you're too young, those are both things she did.
Have to bring him back to life.
What? Are you serious?
It's the only thing that'll snap him out of it.
Well, maybe, but what if I try it with a basketball? Awakenings! Oh, God, that broke his nose. He didn't even flinch. It's bad. Let's do your thing. Let's twirl some toilet paper up into his nose and then when we'll do your thing.
You'll meet a breed with whichever male dog wins the competition.
What, like breed?
I know it might seem odd to you, but this happens in the dog show world. I have to have sex with whichever male dog wins, whoever that ends up being.
Stewie, we're entering a dog show.
But maybe we should just focus on getting ready for the show.
Well, look who wants to be prepared. You're a regular Beagle Scout.
Wait, shouldn't I be the one who clicks if I like the joke? You can't just click after everything you say.
If it's funny, I can. And so far, they've all landed. Unlike the planes on 9/11.
See? No click. That one was in poor taste. Not funny.
You know, I was supposed to be on one of...
That's hilarious. Good luck, Brian.
Chris, you gotta snap out of this. I mean, I've been where you're at. Listen, I've never told anyone this, but I killed a jaywalker in 2002. You're okay!
But I saw him die. That can only mean one thing. He must be a zombie!
What? No, what?
Stop! What the hell are you doing?
I've seen The Walking Dead! I have to destroy your brain and then talk about it for the next hour!
Chris, take it easy!
Mom died.
Seriously?
How you doing? You feeling good? Because this thing is going to come down to the arbitrary whims of whatever elderly volunteers were able to get transportation here on a Tuesday.
Yeah, I...
Hey, watch it! The hell's his problem? Man, thank you for all your help, Stewie. I really couldn't have done it. What the? What's going on? This is it? It's happening right here? Right now?
Uh-huh. They have to certify the union, Brian.
Stud is ready to mount. Please turn up the lights.
What? No, the opposite. In fact, could someone maybe turn on...
I'm sorry, Brian, but this is what I was trying to tell you.
I'm sorry, too, but I see now that you were right. I'm just not sure how this could work or how our relationship could fit into your world.
Hey, let's talk.
I guess this is goodbye.
I guess it is. I'll always remember you, Brian.
And I'll always remember you, Ellie.
I promise to name one of the...
Vegan preschool Chris, Nosy Valley, young Lois, German guy, lots of dogs, Arthur Valentine.
We didn't write an ending, so we're all together trying to make it better.
They didn't write an ending, but what the heck, I still take the check.